you for entertaining us. For the first question, Pop, sir, what is gender stereotyping?
Well, gender stereotyping is basically giving a label or giving an attachment to a particular gender. Without, sometimes it's not logical, that's why this is called stereotyping. Okay.
For the second question, sir, what is or are the causes of gender stereotyping?
Most of the feminist movement, they would say that this is based on history. So in the past, we're living in a patriarchal society, and therefore, since predominantly men, therefore, women are in the disadvantaged situation. I partly believe that because nowadays there have been some improvement in the situation, so gender stereotyping has improved from its previous form. Nowadays there are already some kind of trying to be more objective in attaching roles, no, and giving assignments or roles to a particular gender.
So, what are the effects of gender stereotyping?
I think it puts a particular gender to a disadvantage. No? For instance, I think one example of gender stereotyping is that if you're familiar with the glass ceiling effect, no? Glass ceiling effect is basically there are certain positions in society or organization that women can only occupy. No? If you will notice, we can recognize the fact that there are a lot of managers, supervisors who are women, but not many women are the COO or the COO. Apparently, there's a certain position that women can only occupy, so you call that the glass ceiling effect. So, in a sense, the people that set certain genders are put in a disadvantaged situation.
So, sir, aside from that, what are the usual stereotypes for women?
Well, of course, this stereotype for women are, well, women are physically, I mean, men are physically stronger than women. So that's a stereotype. That's why if work related to physical strength is assigned to men. For example, may mga role naman, halimbawa, pagkukuha ng minutes ng meeting, no? Secretarial work, so usually assigned to women. Collecting monies, no? Kanina yan, usually assigned to women. So, these are, sometimes, it puts one gender to disadvantage at the same time put the other in an advantage. No? I think one concrete example would be in a meeting, let's say a community meeting. So, a good way of gauging whether they are gender sensitive, 50% of the participants are men, 50% of the participants are women. No? But it's not as easy as that because the next question is, who's presiding the meeting? Lalaki ba or babae? Yun, sino yung nagmi-minutes ng meeting? Lalaki ba or babae? So, those roles are sometimes being attached to a particular genders because of the notion that one can deliver the role better than the other.
So, how about for men? What
kind
of usual stereotypes?
Well, yun, I think the stereotyping, men are supposed to be siya yung breadwinner in the family. So, men should be stronger. Some would say, men don't cry, no? What else? And a lot of things that men are not emotional, no? Women are emotional. Men do not open their, you know, feelings, so on and so forth, no? I think those are the common notions or stereotyping of men in the present time and age.
Sir, are these gender stereotypes still applicable?
Yes, I think very much. I think this is a serious concern. because sometimes people might have an idea that they are trying, for example, in our organization, sometimes they're promoting one over the other because of gender, which is not supposed to be the case, no? So the basis of promotion in a particular position should be based on merit, potential, education, qualification, experience, but not gender. So gender should not be a basis for a decision.
So are you saying that gender stereotype is not correct?
Well, in a sense, I am a male. I am more or less advantageous in the patriarchal society. But I would say there should be a better way of addressing gender issue. I think both men and women should be put in an equal footing. In a level playing field, wherein if there is a competition, one should not be regarded as weaker than the other because of gender. Okay, I would strongly believe that whatever man can do, women can, and whatever women can do, men can. So, gone are the days that a particular role, for example, carpentry, should also always be given to men. Why don't we give carpentry, welding to women? Why don't we assign men to do household chores, what else, cooking? No? Because the assigned roles are things of the past. No? These are something that, you know, still holding us and make us biased to a particular... In a sense, we are now having this concept of house husband, no? So, hindi na lahat ng mga lalaki ay, breadwinner of the family, no? Pwedeng one day a couple decides that the man will be the one staying at home and take care of the children and the wife. So, that's a decision, but it doesn't mean that the man in that household is weaker, and that make him less of a person.
Thank you, sir.
Okay.
Thank you, sir.